Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, distributed system is the election algorithm. So what is the selection algorithm? You already know the term. Whenever you are seeing election means, you'll get an idea that we are electing some people. Means you are making something as a leader. Okay, elections, where you keep the elections, whenever you want to select a particular person as a coordinator, then you make it keep an election. So in the same way, if you want to make any one of the processor in the network to make it as a coordinator, here also you need to keep an election. So that is how this election algorithm will be established and what are the different techniques that we use it to implement this election algorithm. Okay, so in this video I want to explain you what is exactly the election algorithm is and what are the types of election algorithm. Now let's see. The many distributed algorithms need one process to act as a coordinator. Okay, so the thing is, so many distributed algorithms are there. So many distributed algorithms are needed. So for that, one process to act as a coordinator. So here one process need to act as a coordinator. So for that, we need to use the election algorithm. The election algorithm is a technique to pick a unique coordinator, that is a leader election. Means your coordinator means it's nothing but a leader. You are going to pick a unique leader. How I can pick a unique leader in so many of the processes? Okay, how we are going to decide which is having the capability of doing the maintaining the coordinator? So now let's see. Some examples are take over the role of the failed processor and pick a master in the Berkeley clock synchronization algorithm. Means some example here. Now let's see what are the different types of election algorithm. The different types of election algorithm is Bully algorithm and Ring algorithm. Okay. So in this video, I want to explain you what exactly the Bully algorithm is and with an examples. And next is the Ring algorithm with an example. Okay, so first let's see the algorithm, Bully algorithm. So before going to see the algorithm, what is exactly the Bully algorithm is, what it is going to be do. Okay, if you know the concept, then you can easily implement the algorithm and with the help of the algorithm, you can solve the problem also, right? Now let's see Bully algorithm. Here each process has a unique numerical ID. Means whatever the processor that are participating in the network, each processor is having a unique numerical ID. Let us take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. Each process in the network is having a unique numerical ID. So that is the first thing. Next, the concept of Bully algorithm is we need to elect one process as a coordinator. The process knows the IDs and address of every other processor. So let us assume each process knows the address of the other's ID as well as the, okay. So as well as the connection address of each process and knows these IDs. Means the 4 knows the ID of the next processor and the address, and the 4 knows the address of the third processor and the ID. Now communication is assumed reliable. Let us assume the communication is reliable. So what is the main key idea of this Bully algorithm? It selects the process with the highest ID. So this is the main thing. So how I am going to make one process as a coordinator? By selecting the process with the highest ID. So which is having the highest ID here? The 5 is having the highest ID. So I make it as a coordinator. So that is a main key idea of Bully algorithm. So if you know the highest ID, you can easily assign. But how I can know that process is having the highest ID? Whether it is in active or inactive, how I know? So that, let's see here. The process initiates elections if it is just recovered from failure or if coordinator failed. Suppose if any one of the coordinator is failed, then the election will be started. So that is the thing. Suppose if one person is acting as some, suppose in the chief minister or prime minister, suppose if that person is resigned or he removed from that position, means another person has to be elected. In the same way, if the one process if coordinator is failed, then the process initiates the election. So any one of the process can initiate the election who recognize the failed node. Okay, if anyone is recognized the failed node, then that process can initiate the election. Okay, if suppose the 5 is the highest, it is failed. So any one of the processor, either 3 or 2 or 4, whatever the processor that has identified the coordinator failed, that process can initiate in the elections. The several processes can initiate elections simultaneously. So, okay, the several processes can also initiate elections simultaneously. And the order of n squared message requires with n process. Now, let's see the algorithm. So, in this video, I'll just explain the algorithm and next I'll explain with an example. So, don't forget to see that example. So, if you see the example, then you clearly understand what exactly the algorithm is. Okay, some people may understand the algorithm by seeing algorithm, they can implement the example, and some students can by seeing the example they can write the algorithm. Okay, the different people can take the information in different ways, right? So now let's see the algorithm. If you didn't understand the algorithm, don't confused. Let's see the example in the next video, whatever I explain in the next video, then you will understand the algorithm. Suppose a process P sends a message to the coordinator. So let us take one process that sends a message to the coordinator. It wants to send a message to the coordinator. Coordinator means he is the elected person. If coordinator does not respond it, suppose this coordinator is not responding to it within a time of interval T, then this process assumed the coordinator is failed. Okay, that is the first step. The first step is, suppose P wants to send a message. Okay, I want to send a message to the some officer. Okay, let's say I want to send a message to this any one of the person. If that person is not respond within a time, what I think? That may be a failed. Then it is assumed that the coordinator has failed. So then next, what step it is do? So I am explaining the Bully algorithm, students. Now, process P sends an election message to every process with a high priority numbers. So, now what this process will do? The process, this is a P0. Let's take. Now, it initiate every process with the highest number to involve in the elections. So, because this process is recognized that the coordinator is failed, then it becomes initiation and sends an election message to every process with the high priority numbers. When compared to this, then another process should be high priority. It wait for response. So, now P0 is wait for response. So, let us take if no one respond for time T, let's take P0 doesn't receive any message from the remaining processor. Then what it does? The P0 itself elects as a coordinator. That is one rule. If any processor is not respond with any OK message, whenever this P0 is asked for elections, if these processor are not respond, let us take if they are not respond, then it takes within a time interval, then itself as a coordinator. Then it sends a message to all lower priorities. Then it sends to message to the lower priorities like P0-1, P0-2 and P0-3. That is the lower messages. Okay. Lower priority numbers that is elected as a new coordinate by saying I am the coordinator. Okay. I am the coordinator. Means if these processor are not responding, it sends a message to the lower processor by saying I am the coordinator, new coordinator. Let us take, suppose, however, if an answer is received within a time, let us take this P0 receives a message from P1, P2, let's take P3, suppose P5 is crashed. So, let us take this P0 receives a message within a time from any other processor like OK. So, whenever it receives a message OK, now the process P again waits for time interval T to receive another message from Q, then it has been elected as a coordinator. If Q does not respond within a time T interval, then it is assumed to have a fail and algorithm is restarted. So it waits until time. So whenever it receives a OK message, it handovers that message to the other processor and it will discard from elections. Because it handovers a role to this processor. Now these processes will play in the role. Now P1 initiate P2 and P3. If anyone sends a OK message, then it handovers that role to the highest priority. Like that, they are selecting the highest priorities. So this is an algorithm for the Boolean algorithm. So in the next video, I explain with an example. Thank you.